Thanks for joining Rudy and me. We're studying the Gospel of Matthew. We're in chapter 23 today. I was walking into Frick and Frack, and one of Rudy's friends and mine got me on the street and said, "What are you talking about?" I said, "We're talking about scribes, Pharisees, and old Baptist preachers." So there'll be a fair amount in here that we need to look at and all of us examine ourselves. Jesus said to the crowd in verse 1 and to his disciples, "The scribes and Pharisees sit on Moses' seat. Therefore do whatever they teach you and follow it, but don't do as they do, for they do not practice what they teach. They tie up heavy burdens, hard to bear, and lay them on men's shoulders and others, and they themselves are unwilling to lift a finger to move them. They do all their deeds to be seen by others. They make their phylacteries broad and their fringes long. They love to have places of honor at banquets and at the best seats in the synagogues, and to be greeted with respect in the marketplace, and to have people call them rabbi." Let's stop there. Those are some of the things they're doing. He's going to tell them don't be like them. But let's start with this. Rudy, pick something there and kind of explain it.
Well, the Lord is, and Jesus is instructing us to look at what people say and what they do. Mm-hmm. And Jesus is really saying here, I believe, that what the Pharisees are saying about the law has truth. Mm-hmm. But the hypocrisy of it all is that even though they know that, they're not doing it. Mm-hmm. So Jesus is asking us to separate what people say from what they do, because if they don't come together, mm-hmm. there's really something wrong.
Sure.
And more than somebody else, I think maybe we should start with ourselves.
Right.
We need to say what we mean and do what we say.
Yeah. Yeah.
And that's hard.
Oh, without a doubt. So the part that most speaks to me here is the idea that they place heavy burdens on people, but then they don't lift a finger to help them. And that has been a challenge to me in my preaching and teaching over the years. And I said, if I'm going to tell people to do something, then I need to also help them know how to do it. So it's not just lay a big burden on people, but it's also to show them this is the principles that the Lord has given us, how we can live that out.
Well, I think that that's a good way to think about it, but the heavy burdens that Jesus is speaking about about the Pharisees is that they actually have, and this goes back to the stone that people rejected.
Right.
They have interpreted the law to a certain degree that the scripture really never, the spirit of the scripture was never in.
Right.
And it became really, instead of why you do it, who does it better?
Right.
And so the heavy burden, I believe, that was that the Pharisees, Sadducees were putting on people is the exact way to do everything.
Yeah.
And it became, you know, like, is this perfect enough?
Right.
And perfectness was ascribed, you know, was thought about as being righteous rather than faith being righteous.
Right.
So when you begin to think like that, and it actually stretches your faith away from believing, and that's how it turned into works.
Yeah, so true. Jesus in chapter 11 of Matthew said, "Come to me, all you who are labor and heavy laden, and I'll give you rest. Take my yoke upon you, different from that yoke, and learn from me, for my yoke is gentle and light." I didn't completely quote that. Let's read on.
No, but that's the spirit.
That's the spirit. So if you're looking for how to do this, look to Jesus. I'd like to go to verse 8. You're not to be called rabbi, for you have one teacher. You are brothers and sisters. And call no one father on earth, for you have one father, the one in heaven. Nor are you to be called instructors, for you have one instructor, the Messiah. The greatest among you shall be your servant, and all who exalt themselves will be humbled, and those who humble themselves will be exalted. Why don't you chime in on that?
Well, I think through the prophets and the Psalms, really, David is a prophet.
Uh-huh.
And we find that what is God looking for but a humble and contrite spirit? Mm-hmm. The beginning of wisdom is basically the fear of the Lord.
Right.
And so what does fear do? It usually it makes you afraid. It has the ability, in some instances, has the ability to humble you. And really, for me, and I'm humbled by what I don't do. And really, when that is just put before me, it breaks my heart, because I know who really it's hurting the most. It's not really me or the other person, but really the Lord. And yet, it's equivalent almost of hurting the other person too, because that's actually probably what, that's in line with how the Lord works. It's like, I'm always asking Father Jesus to show me how to love the person the way that he loves them. And it's hard to hold that thought when I'm being challenged.
Yeah, so true. So I look at this and he's basically calling out status. So he is saying to us, don't give to other people status that really belongs to God alone. And don't assume status for yourself. And so, and that is become a servant.
Right, and when you assume status for yourself, you begin thinking of yourself more highly than you should.
Yeah.
And really, that's deadly.
Oh yeah.
It pride is probably the most deadly sin of them all.
Yeah. That thought in our head, if you only knew who I am, you know, that doesn't do well in this world. And yet there are times when that thought floats in my mind, if you knew who I was, you'd treat me differently. And Jesus says, give it up, Bob. That doesn't work.
Yeah, that's the cross that I'm bearing most of the time, is like, I just am so prideful.
Yeah.
And, you know, I know it a second later.
Right.
But I don't know it at the right time, and that's really what I would have the Lord help me to do.
You got to pray for us.
Father, help us to come to you humbly and brokenhearted, Father. Father, not brokenhearted to the extent that we don't think there's a way out. We come to you because we know that you are the way. Help us to see what you want us to see, Father. Help me, Father, see the way you act, in Jesus' name.
That's right. Amen. Rudy, thank you. Thank you all so much. For the next couple of days, we're going to beat up Baptist preachers, scribes, and Pharisees. I'm a Baptist preacher, and we'll do that. All right?
Woe to you.
Woe to you. Take care. Have a good day.